So in NMR, our first topic was chemical shift, and now we've moved on to multiplicity. Multiplicity gets into the idea of our peak shape. Peaks in the NMR in an NMR spectrum tend to have distinct shapes, and this is the peak multiplicity. So multiplicity of a peak is determined by the neighboring hydrogens to any given hydrogen. And so we're going to count the number of neighboring hydrogens. That's going to be this value n. So let's look at a simple structure. This is chloroethane. These two hydrogens are identical by symmetry. It's a CH2 group. So those two hydrogens are going to show up together. These two hydrogens have three neighbors. So these hydrogens are attached to this carbon. Here's our neighboring carbon. And these three hydrogens are considered neighbors. So these two hydrogens have three neighbors. Three vicinal neighbors. N equals 3. These three hydrogens, on the other hand, have two neighbors. So these hydrogens have two neighbors. And for those hydrogens, N is going to equal 2. So these hydrogens on the right are going to have a different peak shape, a different multiplicity than the hydrogens on the left. All right, okay. So peak multiplicity is the number of neighboring hydrogens plus 1. So if you have a poor hydrogen that has no neighbors, its multiplicity is not 0. Its multiplicity will be number of neighbors plus 1. It'll be 1. And so we name these. So if multiplicity is 1, which you only get with 0 neighbors, then it's going to be a singlet. If n equals 1, then it's going to be a doublet. N equals 2, it's going to be a triplet, and so forth. And this is set up by Pascal's triangle, and that's this graphic right here. So if n equals 0, no neighbors, then the multiplicity equals 1, and we're going to have a single peak for that. That's going to be a singlet. If n equals 1, we have one neighbor, then the multiplicity equals 2, and we call this thing a doublet. Why call it a doublet? Because there are going to be two peaks. And moreover, Pascal's triangle tells us the two peaks are going to have an intensity of 1 to 1. Okay, I'm not going to fill out this whole thing, but if n equals 2, the multiplicity is going to be 3, and this is going to be a triplet. What's the relative intensity of those peaks? Well, it's going to be 1 to 2 to 1 is the relative intensity. And so these are going to have distinctive shapes. Let's not get lost in Pascal's triangle. Let's see how it applies in two examples. Okay, here's a nice simple example. Diethyl ether. I'm going to draw it in a condensed format. These three hydrogens have how many neighbors? Well, they have two neighbors. They have two neighbors. Therefore, number of neighbors equals 2. And the multiplicity equals 3. This is going to be a triplet. And the triplet should have an intensity of 1 to 2 to 1. So where are those? Well, here, this is a triplet. Three peaks. And they have an intensity of about 1 to 2. To 1. So these hydrogens, let's label these hydrogens A, are those. That's our triplet. And by symmetry, these three hydrogens are identical, so those are also A, and they all show up on top of each other. How about these hydrogens? These hydrogens are on a carbon, and there's a next door carbon, and they're the three neighbors. So these have three neighbors. And so their multiplicity is going to equal 4. And for 4, we call those a quartet. And if we were to turn back the page for the quartet, back the page, they should have a 1 to 3 to 3 to 1 ratio. And this is about 1 to 3 to 3 to 1 intensity. This is our quartet. So these hydrogens in this molecule, whether we're talking about the methyl group or the CH2 group, they are really different. They have a totally different peak shape. Those signals for those hydrogens have a different multiplicity. And when we look at the spectrum, it's very apparent. Oh yeah, that's a pattern of four. That's a quartet. That is a pattern of three. That's a triplet. And it even has the right intensity levels. So let's look at another example. Well, here's propylbenzene. The benzene ring, all of these hydrogens on the benzene ring, they show up in the, in the 6.5 to 8 window, and they all lump together here. They don't have a distinct multiplicity. Not all hydrogens show pretty multiplicities. But we have this CH3, we have this CH2, we have this CH2. This CH2 has two neighbors. These should be a triplet. This CH2 is flanked by not only that CH3, but that CH2. This thing has five neighbors. That's a big one. So the multiplicity equals six. That's that one right there. This one's a triplet. Let's label these A, B, and C. That's going to be A. There's our triplet. This is our sextet. And then this methyl group on the end, this CH3, has two neighbors. This is also going to be a triplet. And that's C right there. So that's how we walk through multiplicity. We look at the peak shapes. This is one signal, but it has a multiplicity to describe the shape of the signal. And likewise, this is one signal, and that's one signal. That one peak has a spread, a pattern that we refer to as the multiplicity.